start with the new identity today. The four identity we discussed in the last lecture. Now this one is the new identity. It is x plus y plus z the whole square. We have seen the perfect square for the two terms, x plus y the whole square. Now it is z also. So now let's see that how it should be simplified. Again it's quite easy. So what we'll do, square of bracket, square of bracket, square of bracket. You have to do this, then plus 2 to bracket, plus 2 to bracket, and plus 2 to bracket. It's quite easy to remember. What I have done, there are 3 terms, so I have written the square of all the 3 terms, plus there are 3 terms, so 2 bracket, 2 to bracket, and 2 to bracket. Now here it should be first term, second term, third term, first term, second term, third term, and first term. So this is the formula. It is x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. Let's see one question. Question number 4. Let's see one of the sum. It is given x plus 2y plus 4z the whole square. So as we have done this method, it is the same. The identification, there are 3 terms and the power is 2. See, the sign is not always plus. It can be minus, it can be minus, both can be minus. So we'll see how to do this. But when we simplify, we should remember we never change the sign of this which we have written between the two terms. See this. Square plus square plus square plus 2 to bracket plus 2 to bracket plus 2 to bracket. The same formula I have written. Now here it should be x, that is first term, second term, third term. Then second term, third term, and third term, first term. See, it is quite easy. Now let's simplify. It is x square plus 2y the square, it is 4y square plus 4z square, 16z square plus 2 to the 4xy plus 2 to the 4, 4 to the 4 is 16yz plus 4 to the 8xz. You can write zx also. So this is the easiest way to simplify. Let's continue with same kind of sum. Let's see one more question. So again it is x plus y plus z the whole square. But you can see that here the two signs are negative. So don't worry. Let's see that how to simplify. The formula will remain same. We'll do the same. A square, x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy. See, I'm not changing the sign anywhere. Plus 2 to bracket. Plus 2 to bracket. So you can see that I have written the plus between the terms. This is 3a. You can see that second term is negative. So I have written the negative into the bracket. So that is the important thing you should remember. First term, second term, third term. Now 2 into first term, second term. Then second term, third term. Then third term and first term. So let us do the simplification. 3a the square. So 3 3s are 9 a square. When we do the square, it is always positive. So plus 49b square. Again the square will be positive. So this both the term, why they become positive? Because they have the square. Now as it is negative, so plus minus minus, 3 to the 6, 6, 7 is a 42ab. It's 2 minus, so minus minus plus. 7 to the 14bc. 1 term minus, so minus 3 to the 6ca. So now this is called the expansion of this given question. Let's see one more question of the same type. But you can see that here the terms are given into the fraction. So don't worry. Let us write this as a by 4, this as b by 2 and plus 1. So the formula won't be changed, only the terms are into the fraction. So the formula is square of first plus square of second plus square of third plus 2 to bracket plus 2 to bracket plus 2 to bracket. So now here it should be the first term, a by 4, should be the second, you can remember the second term is negative, so minus. then third term, then first term, second term. See, the term which is negative should remain the sign negative only. Second term, third term, third term, first term. Let's expand this. It is a square by 4 4s are 16. As we discussed earlier, the negative become positive when we do the square. So b square by 4, square of 1 as well. Now remember friends, whenever the fraction term is there, there must be some cancellation. As it is in the product, so we can do it. Then minus, because only one term is negative. So ab upon 4. This 2 cancel, minus, it's b only. It's plus, the cancellation is there, 2 2's are, so it is a by 2. So this is the expanded form of the given question. Let us do the another question of this exercise, and that is question number 5. So you can see here that question is we have to factorize this. Now which formula is applicable is very important. So let us identify that which formula is applicable. Now you can see that how many terms are there. It is very important. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So whenever the 6 terms are there, you should remember, when the 6 terms are there, out of 6 you can observe this 3 terms which are perfect square and they are positive. So we are going to use this formula. Remember again the identification. Out of 6 terms, 3 terms are positive and perfect square. So whenever it is like this, so it is the same formula which we used in the question 4. That is a plus b plus c the whole square. So let us first convert this into that form. So again this step would be the same that which we have done in the previous. I will do like this, square of first, square of second, square of third. Now plus 2, 2 bracket. Now remember here all the times won't be plus. It based on which sign is given into the question. You should remember all the square terms are positive, but all these terms which are not perfect square, they are not positive, can be negative. So as it was positive, I have written plus 2 bracket, second term negative, so minus 2, 2 bracket. And as it is negative, minus 2, 2 bracket. So you remember this, whenever it is, the terms which are negative should be minus. Now what? It is a square of 2x, see 2x square, that is 4x square. 9y square, so it is 3y. And this is 4z. Now don't look at into this question. Isko hume nahi dekhna. We have to write the answers here from this term. Kaise likhte the? 2 first term, second term. So 2x and 3y. See, you will obtain the same. 2 to the 4, 3 is a 12x square. Then second and third. 3 to the 6, 6 4's are 24. Third and first. So 4 to the 8 to the 16 exact. So this, now what would be the answer? So your answer is 2x, 3y and 4z the whole square. Now you might be surprised that I have not done any sign between the two terms. So now one of the term must be negative. So let's see that which term is negative, that how do we identify. Out of this 3, one term must be negative because there are 2 negative terms which we have. So let us identify out of this 3 which term is negative. So it based on which are the 2 negative terms. Out of this 2 negative terms, look at that which is the common bracket. I repeat, first we have to identify which are the negative terms. Out of this negative terms, we have to identify which are the common bracket. The common bracket is 4z. So 4z is negative, the rest terms are positive. Let's do another sum, and it is an important question. So there are chances that this kind of question will come into the exam. So again the identification, that which formula is applicable. So first you identify how many terms? 6 terms. Out of 6, 1, 2, 3. This 3 which have the square are positive. But you can see that this term is not perfect square as well as this term. But you look at into the rest of the term, there are square root is there. So we have to use the same formula, that is x plus y plus z the whole square. So we write the formula as we discussed. Square, 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 minus 2, as it is minus, that is 1. 2 bracket, then plus, plus 2, 2 bracket, then minus 2, 2 bracket. See, where I have to do the minus, it based on which terms are negative. As it is not a perfect square, we can say that square root 2. So you can see square root 2, the square become 2 and x square. Y square, so it is only y. 8, the square root of 8 we discuss, it is 2 root 2 z. Then no need to see this. Now here the first term, here the second term, here the second term and the third term. Third term and first term. So when you do the product, 2 root 2 xy, 2 to the 4 root 2 yz and 2 to the 4 into 2, 8 xz. So the answer must be root 2x, y and 2 root 2 z the whole square. Now as we discussed earlier that if one of the term is negative, so that must be one term should be negative from this. So let's see that which are the two negative brackets, this two. And which is the common bracket? Minus. So we can say minus root 2 is negative, the rest are positive. If it is like this, sometimes when the first term is negative, you can also write to make that term positive, we can also write the rest of the two terms are negative. This is not compulsorily this step, but both answers are considered to be the correct one. Thank you.